Welcome back, Dynamic Gang. You already know I don't have to say all that. So we're gonna do heart and we're gonna do these dreams. Now I'm a lyricist, so I listen to lyrics, I listen to storytelling. So this song right here, I'm gonna break it down, man, because there's a lot of like there's this one bar that's tough. And I'm gonna let you listen to it and then I'm gonna point it out. But I mean, like, the song by itself is really good. So we're gonna get into it. And just so you haven't, I don't know if you realize, but it has the 80s feel to it because it's from the 80s. But don't sleep on this. This is still a banger. It's still a banger. So don't be sleeping on this. You can see that she's storytelling. You know, she's talking about, like, if you got a girl or you ever been with your girl, and you know, she goes to the mall or she goes to, like, one of these, like, beauty stores, and she's putting, like, you know, perfume on her wrist just to smell to see how it is, you know, and then she's talking about the moon, you know, I mean, like, she's storytelling. So that's why you got to listen, you know, like this song right here. Like, I'm a big fan of Slick Rick. So when you talk about storytelling, like, I mean, he's like she's spitting. All right. She's giving you a visual. Darkness on the edge, shadows where I stand. I search for the time on a watch with no hands. Listen to what she said. I search for a time on a watch with no hands, bro. That's a bar. That's a bar right there. Like she's literally telling you, like, she got a watch that doesn't tell time. But it got the hands on it, so it's on her, bro. I'm telling you, man. Like, you gotta listen to the lyrics, man. The lyrics are, you know, and not, you know, like, I don't know who originated, who came up with the phrase bar. Put that down in the comments if you know. But, you know, storytelling in songs is a big plus for me, and it makes me really think. It makes me paint a visual. Listen, that's what really made me impressed by this song. I'm gonna run that back so you can hear it. Does this listen to what she says? How tough that is, yo. She walks through without a cut through a stained glass. What, bro? That's a tough line. That's a tough line. If you're a hip hop head and you're a real music, like music is universal to you, you will admit that that's a tough line. Like that's definitely tough. I'm saying the whole song's tough, but that's what draw me near. That's what I'm saying. Like, the whole visuals, everything is all good, but damn, bro, like, that right there got it. Like, I don't know about you, man, but at night, I will put 80s on and cruise. Like I'm telling you, man. Like, I'm telling you, like, that whole cruising. That's a shout out to, like, a lot of references in movies, you know, with the spirits and stuff like that. Like remember in Ghost, like there's certain scenes where like you don't see their feet, but you think you're dreaming, but you're not. And it's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like an illusion, bro. I'm telling you, man, that's some tough writing right there. In a wood full of princes, that was Heart, These Dreams. Classic, a classic song, man. Like, you know, like I said, man, like, I'm up on the newer school, like, hip hop. And, you know, like I said, I had to go through some stuff in order to get to where I am right now. But now I go back and I listen to lyrics, man. And to me, the lyrics are, you know, they hit, you know, and there's some stories. If you listen to the words, there's a story developing. We are gonna do a reaction to Slick Rick. I think it's bedtime or story time. It's one of those. Slick Rick was excellent on telling stories. You can have the whole story unfold in your head. That's why John Lucas is so good. You know, there's I forgot the name of the song, but he was talking about how he got shot by the car. Like, he was taken to this location and then he was shot, but then he didn't die right away. But I'm telling you, we gonna react to that too. Story, lyrics, that's what I love. And to me, that's real hip-hop. Because that's coming from your heart. That's coming from your soul. That's like, you know what I'm saying? That's why, you know, I understand that when you, again, I understand that maybe the ghostwriter that's writing the stuff doesn't have a good delivery, doesn't have a good cadence, so he can't, you know, express himself, but he could write like his ass off. You know, like Ice Cube. Ice Cube was good at writing. But it was Eazy-E that was doing all that crazy stuff. And Ice Cube was the one that was just writing it down, you know. And I'm not taking it from Ice Cube, because Ice Cube, you know, he was doing his thing. But Eazy-E was the gangster, the whole group, you know, with the whole group. And he wasn't a rapper, but he lived that life. He lived the life that was on the street. Big shout out to Eazy-E, man. Rest in peace. And he broke away. He made Bone Thugs and Harmony. And, you know, even though Ice Cube and Dr. Dre and everything, they had like a falling out from N.W.A., you know, it's classic, man. It's classic. And I'm sure towards the end, they would want to bury the hatchet, man. Like, I'm sure nobody wants to continue their beef and everything. The same thing with Tupac and Biggie. I'm sure at one point of their life, if they were still living together, like if they were still alive, I'm sure they would have crushed that beef too. Because there's no reason to have, you know, that junk was just crazy, man. Like the 90s was crazy. Like, it really was. Like people want to talk about the 90s, it's
It was like a lot of people say, Wild Wild West. It was crazy. And, you know, all these rappers now, and I'm going to put quotations, all these rappers now that are internet sensations, bro, half of the shit they talk about, they don't do. That's why I don't mess with them. That's why I'm like, don't say, you know, like if you don't shoot, don't rap that you shot. If you don't do that drug, don't rap like you did that drug. You know, you gotta keep it 100, man. You can't just be rapping just because you know that's gonna sell money. You know, like, you know what? That's why I don't mess with that. That's why I don't mess with that. I'll mess with Curtis Blow. I'll mess with Slick Rick. I'll mess with Kier S1, bro. Like I'll go back in the archives and I'll listen to rappers that, like Biz Markie, you know, when he did all the bit, like the beatboxing, you know, the beatboxing and whatnot. Like nah, man. Listen, you already know what it is. If you like this channel, you already know what to do. I don't have to tell you. All right, let's get it.